And now we come to sentence stress. It's really very important because stressing a particular word in a sentence can change the meaning, not only the meaning, but the tune of the sentence completely. I've got an example of one simple sentence, and we'll take it in turns to stress a different word. The sentence is, take Mel to the theatre on Saturday. Now, I'm going to change Mel, but I'm going to stress Mel because somebody has said to me, I want to take Joan. And I'm going to say, no, not Joan. Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday. Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday. Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday. You like to say that?
Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday.
Now, if we were to change theatre because somebody said, oh, I want to take Mel to the cinema, we have to make sure that they know exactly what we want to do. Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday. Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday.
Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday.
Not the cinema. And the last word, let's change Saturday. Keep Saturday because somebody wants to take her to the theatre on Friday. Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday.
Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday.
Not Sunday or Monday, but Saturday. Can you hear the tune? Take Mel to the theatre on Saturday. I'm being very, very diplomatic, but at the same time, I'm trying to get my point across.
Yeah, very firm.
Very firm in a polite way, as always.
Yes, it was wonderful to listen to these examples, and what I've noticed is that we stress the important word and the most important message that we are going to tell in a sentence. But also we throw away other words that are not stressed. Is that correct?
That is absolutely correct. But the more important thing, we're changing the tune, the inflection in that exercise each time, because we're emphasizing a different word, which means the whole sentence has an up and a down.
Yes, that's right. Before I came to you, English intonation was mystery for me. Mm-hmm. Actually, mystery. I said, oh, how do I reproduce English intonation? Because my intonation is completely different. But then I realized if I stress important words, throw away unimportant words, I am halfway there.
You are halfway there, and it's absolutely right. But I always say to students, it's almost impossible because we have no rules about stressing. When we go up, when we come down, it depends very much on the emotion and the thought behind the person who's speaking. The important thing is to listen to English people, listen to books that are being read, listen to everybody and make a note of when the voice goes up at the end. Sometimes it goes down, sometimes it glides up and down. So it's important just to listen and absorb all that intonation, which
yes,
you did.
Yes, and I've realized that in Russian, for example, people use what we call simple falling all the time. Mm-hmm. And that's why you may sound a little bit rude. Do it. Sort of do it.
Mm.
So that's really interesting. I think if you would like to integrate in English society, you need to try and think about your inflection. Maybe it's not a good idea to use simple falling all the time.
No, no. You feel very depressive then.
Yes.
Does the voice go down?
Yes.
I don't feel very well today. Oh, I think I'll go out to the shops. It's very depressing.
You sound very Russian now.
Oh, no.
Well, of course it was a joke, but it's true. But let's say if you would like to meet a man in a bar and you use this depressing intonation, oh, my day was good. Instead of, my day was wonderful. It
yes.
makes a big difference, doesn't it?
Of course it does. Of course it does.
Well, I think this lesson is incredibly useful, and you can find it in our book, Get Rid of Your Accent, Advanced Level, and in our app, Fluent English Speech. Best of luck, and we see you next time.
Bye.